Now, they have got speed and they have got depth. Two pretty good ingredients if you want to win. And they've got a crowd here.
You know, Steve, I know you're from Kansas City, but you're looking at the University of Louisville cheerleaders, and I don't know if you knew this or not, but they won a national championship a year ago.
Absolutely.
Also.
Not only beautiful, but athletic. And there is a togetherness with this ball club. It'll be tough to hear tonight, and we're not playing at Freedom Hall. We're playing in Cincinnati on the banks of the Ohio, and it seems like it's a home game for Louisville, even though Miami, Ohio's got a good contingent down here.
Well, you know, Kentucky is a basketball state for the most part, and these Louisville fans have been anxious for the basketball season to get started. Miami with high expectations for this 1985-86 season because they are a favorite of the Mid-American Conference. Let's go to the PA announcer, red pitcher, for our starting lineup.
The Big Apple NIT doubleheader, this one featuring the Miami Redskins and the University of Louisville Cardinals. Here are the starting lineups. Miami is designated as the visiting team, starting at forward, number 34, a 6'6 senior out of Dayton, Ron Harper. At forward, a 6'7 sophomore, number 44, from Anderson, Indiana, Lamont Hanna. At center, number 33, a 6'8 senior out of Hamilton, Tim Lempe. At guard, number 5, a sophomore from Lebanon, Indiana, Eddie Schilling. And at guard, number 10, a junior from Toledo, Eric Newsom. Coaching the Redskins in his second year after guiding them to the NCAA, former Redskin player Jerry Pearson. Now for the Cardinals. At forward, number 41, a 6'7 senior sophomore from Louisville, Herbert Brooks. At forward, number 55, a 6'7 senior from Camden, New Jersey, Billy Thompson. At center, number 43, a freshman from Savannah, Georgia, Pervis Ellison. At guard, number 42, a 6'4 senior from Ashland, Kentucky, Jeff Hall. And back this year, guard number 20, 6'5 senior from Camden, New Jersey, Milt Wagner. And the coach of the Cardinals, third among active coaches in winning percentage, Denny Brum. And boy, Steve Grad, you can feel the excitement in this air tonight as the anticipation of both of these teams opening up the 1985-86 season.
Denny giving them some last-minute instructions. And, you know, they'll be using a lot of switching on defense. A lot of guys will be on Harper. Again, Denny admits that Miami at this time of year is a little ahead of his boys. And it'll be interesting to watch Miami's triangle offense that they go to, and just move that triangle around.
It'll be Harper at 6'6 and a half and Ellison at 6'10 in Miami. Controls the opening tip. This is Eddie Schilling. He's the quarterback of the club, and Louisville, as expected, opens in a man-to-man. Harper didn't waste any time to pick up the slack from the last year when he was an All-American candidate. Thompson is slapped on the air. The officials, Mickey Crowley, Larry Limbo, and Timmy Higgins.
Watch Lamont Hanna direct Thompson as Thompson went by him. First ball of the game.
And they say, Steve, that the foul came on the movement toward the basket. So Thompson triggers it in the hall. He'll watch it.
An outstanding double screen set up by Cook and by Ellison.
And here's that patented full-court pressure by Louisville. Harper needs some help. Throw it away.
Schilling sacrificed his body trying to save it. He landed on a radio crew.
They were loose over there. Here's Ellison, the fine freshman. He's getting a lot of pressure from Lampy. Hall misses everything. And Hanna has it for Miami. We're tied at two. We've played a minute in the game. Harper checked by Ellison in the Louisville man-to-man. Schilling, the sophomore, is the quarterback, and this little guy, Newsom, can also make it happen.
They want Schilling to shoot a little more. He has 208 assists last year. They want him to go to the hoop.
This guy will shoot and does. Missed it. Thompson rebounds up to Jeff Hall. Hall trying to chase it down, but loses it to Newsom.
Mid-America Conference fans remember his dad, Manny, at Western Michigan, the all-time leading scorer back in the early 60s, 62 to 64. He likes to shoot, too, just like Daddy.
Schilling checked by Hall. This is Newsom against Wagner. Wagner about 4 inches taller. 45-second shot clock in effect this year in college basketball, and a turnover by the Redskins.
Lamont Hanna unable to hold on to that.
There's Wagner looking for his first two of some time, but he lost the ball. And he fouled in frustration. First Louisville foul of the game, and it comes on number 20, Milt Wagner. As I mentioned, the 45-second shot clock is in effect for the entire game, including in overtime, and also this year in the NCAA tournament. One of the major changes in college basketball this year.
And a good chance.
No question about it. And here's that half-court trap, and Newsom gets through a lot of traffic. We're tied at two. Harper missed it badly, but Newsom was on the other side. He will try and hit.
Newsom averaged over 17 points a game last year. You can see why with that shot.
Cook, who has been a pleasant surprise in the preseason. Thompson down low, puts it in.
Billy Thompson, the only regular not hurt last year for the Cardinals, picks up where he left off.
Newsom trying to dribble and does through all that Cardinal pressure. We are tied at four. We've played almost 3 minutes. Lampy trapped.
That's what a good defense will do, force those mistakes.
17:05 remaining in the first half. Louisville and Miami tied at four. Glad you're with us tonight for Big Apple NIT action. It's exciting. Tulsa won the first game in overtime over Dayton. I'm Don Russell along with Steve Grad, and we're so pleased to have you with us for the beginning of another Louisville Cardinal basketball year here on TV 41. And Thompson got their wires crossed and an unforced turnover that time.
There's Jerry Pearson trying to wake his team up. We're tied in the early going.
Some fine, fine coaches in this NIT.
Five, at least than 5'8 and a half. Newsom's got to be closer to 5'5 or 5'6, and he's always mismatched.
He is not very big, I know that. He will launch it, though, over Crook and rimmed it. Ellison kept it alive, then Harper has it rejected by Ellison. Excuse me, that was Hannah that shot. Here come the Cardinals on the run. Hall under pressure, partially blocked. The Crook gets it, has it slapped away, and Schilling gets the foul.
Is this the first game of the season, or is this a tournament game after a full schedule? Non-stop. You see it from where they see it. He blocks it. I'll tell you, Pervis Ellison, one of the few freshmen that Trumbull just rave about. Here's Billy coming back. It dishes off. And the Schilling reach.
Herbert Crook at the line. Herbert, 65%. A free throw shooter last year. Gets his first point. And you know what? The thing about it, Steve Grad, Herbert Crook is on the all-freshman team, but he only started one game last year. And he's been the most impressive player in preseason statistically.
Yes, and everybody in the scrimmage. He's got more nicknames than anybody on the team. Superb Herb, Rubber Man, the Snake.
Louisville leads by two, 16:02 on the Riverfront Coliseum clock. Here's a steal by Thompson. It's 3-on-2. Crook will follow.
The word on Crook is he's a great offensive rebounder, and that's why the scouts say that.
The Cardinals have doubled the score. Newsom with good penetration over Ellison, and Ellison gets the foul. And you talk about a mismatch, Steve Grant.
Well, Ellison 6'9". We told you Newsom is certainly not 5'8". Quick hands will always beat everything else. Quick, good old Milt to Philly. Another look at it, a pick of clean. And now against Ellison, 6'9 against 5'6". Ellison, the freshman. You think he was a little nervous prior to the game? He tried to conceal it.
You know, we saw him shoot today, Steve, and I thought he looked a little nervous in, and I think you're right. It was pretty obvious he was trying to act like, hey, guys, it's no big deal, but it was. 15:36 remaining in the first half here at the Coliseum. It's Louisville 8, Miami 6, and we'll have more NIT action in just a moment. Okay.
Officials?
Yeah. To a quick start offensively in the first half here, Steve Grad, as Louisville leading by two, and look at that shooting percentage for the Cardinals.
60%, Miami's 33%. Miami really has had to rush it a little bit. The defense on Louisville has been outstanding. 4 points for Crook. Newsom has four for Miami.
Are you surprised about the pace of this game?
Yes, I am, absolutely. Absolutely. Miami hasn't had a chance to catch its breath, although they've almost given it back as much as they've taken to the Cardinals.
And now the Redskins will apply some mild backcourt pressure, looking to trap. Wagner, who was a first-team All-American preseason last year, down with that injury, is back and seems to be full strength, and he'll try to get the bucket. Harper, who can do it all and is an outstanding youngster, will try to tie it up but can't. And Newsom with the follow.
They should never have let Newsom get that rebound.
Wagner behind the back. Oh,
unless Miami slows it down, they'll be in for a long night. As you see, Milt behind the back with a picture-perfect pass to Hall. Miami can't get into a contest like that with Louisville or they'll be in real trouble.
Harper through the lane. Ellison rejects it and picks up the loose ball to Thompson for the jam. Steve, they cannot get into this type of game.
Hey, what a morale booster is Ellison blocking Harper. What a thing for the freshman to do to block an All-American candidate like that.
6 minutes into the game, Louisville 12, Miami 6. And now things start to quiet down just a little bit. Harper. Pass intercepted after it was tipped away as Wagner gets it up the hall. Crook back to Hall. Thompson to the free throw line. Cardinals are red hot. Gary Pearson wants these and gets a timeout.
This is what really fires up a team. 43, the Pervis Ellison, the freshman, blocking Harper. And that is what started this. Then, the outlet baseball pass. Is Billy Thompson going to put on a show? You know he did. A thing of beauty. Miami turnovers have really killed the Redskins.
You know, and the pace of the game's done that.
Milt Wagner, one of the great passers in the game. His timing isn't hurt. Oh, brother, to Hall. And the great thing is that Wagner is totally recovered from his injury on that right foot. And that toe. No problems at all in the scrimmages. He's the old Milt Wagner.
Louisville continues to be red hot from the field, 67%, and Miami only 22%. As you look at the score now, as we have 13:25 remaining in the first half, and again, the Cardinals off to a quick start, but Miami is doing exactly what Denny Crum wanted them to do. Tell you what, these Louisville fans went to New York last year for the finals of the NIT. They love to go anywhere, I can tell you that. And they have just had the frustrations from last year bottled up for a year. And now with the anticipation with the recruiting class, they just were ready to let it explode.
What a great way to start the year with a Big Apple tournament.
Miami after the timeout. This is Lampe, blocked by Thompson. All on the breakaway.
First-rate breakaway buckets have the Cardinals. 6 points.
Harper with it in the backcourt. Brings it up over to Newsom, and now Newsom tries to get it out and does to Schilling. 16-6 as we bring you exciting Cardinal action on TV 41 in Louisville, and glad you're with us tonight.
Harper played in the World University Games with Billy Thompson. But tonight, it's opposite side of the fence.
Thompson, Miami, in the zone defense, and Wagner gets his first 2 points, and it's been a dry spell for Milt just because he's been out of action. It's 18-8. The Cardinals enjoy their largest lead of the game, and Hall will get called for pushing on Newsom. First foul on Jeff Hall, the third on Louisville as a team. A lot of red in here tonight.
The Redskins have got to rebound better. Otherwise, Louisville can blow them out of here with their great speed.
Well, you got Miami in red. You have Dayton that was in red. Louisville's in red.
And Pearson's seeing red with his team down 18-8.
This is Wagner checking Newsom, reached around. Newsom with a left-handed hook shot. Oh, my goodness. Jerry
red.
Pearson is not quite as red. His red coat looks nice, but after Newsom hit that little flat-footed left-handed hook shot, Hook has it stolen away by Harper, and here comes the little guy on the run. And now he wisely backs it out. Harper, they give him the shot, and he'll take that one all day long.
Why not? His range is on the court. That's his range.
6 points for Harper, and now Miami back within six. Cook down low, threw it to Cal for Ellison. And now Harper gets it up to Newsom. Nice move. It will not go, but Hall gets the foul. Second on Jeff Hall, and Miami making a comeback. And now
the Redskins will take the fast break if they can get it. Nice body control by Newsom. It just doesn't fall.
Mark McSwain, number 10, checks in for Louisville as Pervis Ellison will go to the bench. And now another fine freshman, Tony Kimbrough, Mr. Basketball in the state of Kentucky. 6'7", 190-pound freshman from Louisville Seneca High School.
The last time a recruit, as Cook sits down, the last time a freshman recruit comes into a program and as he signs says, now we will go to the national championship. Was Darryl Griffith. The current one is Kimbrough. He said it. Did he back it up?
Well, I guess people will see. Mike Abram, number 34, just checked into the game. Abram, of course, started the last five games through the NIT postseason play last year. He's a sophomore from Muncie, Indiana. And Eric Newsom gets his seventh point of the night. And has an opportunity now to pull Miami within four, and he does exactly that. See the action down low. Billy Thompson as the Cardinals lead by four. We'll be right back. Yeah, if we can get it in there. Okay. Thank you. Okay.
The Denny Crumb Show, 10:30.
4 here in Cincinnati, Ohio, the NIT Big Apple Tournament, and we're glad to have you with you tonight. And don't forget the Denny Crumb Show each Thursday night here on TV 41 at 10:30 p.m. Coach Crumb and Van Vance will preview and look back at all the action of Cardinal basketball, and also this year we'll have a special coaching tip each week. So we hope you'll join Denny Crumb and Van Vance every Thursday night at 10:30 here on TV 41. But we're back to live action here from Cincinnati, Ohio, NIT Big Apple style, and Mike Abram working against the Miami half-court trap. Redskins drop back in a straight zone after the Cardinals set up the offense. Louisville will probably look to post the guards down low, Steve, because Kimbrough is a big guard who just missed his first shot, but Thompson will follow.
Great positioning by the Cardinals. They set excellent screens to Kimbrough. Is big. He's bigger than some of the up men for Miami.
Boy, Harper's a big man, and we'll have an offensive foul on Ron Harper. His first, and you tell me you think these guys aren't going to some basket work here?
Did he get set? Well, he did get set. Their first reunion since those World University games. Boom, diddy boom.
Yeah.
Thompson was in there. He was planted.
They both were on the silver medal team in the World University Games in Japan this past summer. This is Wagner, loves that shot, but didn't get the friendly bounce. McSwain, offensive rebound, will not go, and he charged.
Let's have another look down at the other side. Do they plant? Do they set? Here's McSwain. Hunter was the recipient of that bruising block.
Hey, what? It makes you hurt just seeing some of the contact with these guys. Todd Staker checks into the game.
He's a kid who'll come in. He won't make a lot any mistakes, and that's what he's in there for. He's not much of a shooter, but he won't hurt you.
He's a 6'3 sophomore from Wheelersburg, Ohio. Harper almost traveled with it. As you can tell, the partisan Cardinal fans thought so. But we're reaching the midpoint of the first half with Louisville by 6, but Miami with the ball. Hunter, number 22, Ron Hunter, a 6'4 junior, missed it, and Thompson wanted to run out with the ball before he actually had it.
Harrison urging his team to cut that tempo. You can't get in a horse race at Louisville. They're down by 6.
Newsom working against Abram, pulls up with that quick jumper. Harper with a great rebound, and he bounces it in. I'm not sure he really shot that ball. He lost control of it, but had the presence of mind to push it in the right direction.
Miami on a quick transition defense, but not quick enough.
Because Milt Wagner has his second field goal, and it's 22-16 Louisville. As you look at it from about our location, right at midcourt, moving right toward your screen. Knocked away from Newsom, Thompson up to Wagner. Wagner likes to deal one-on-one. What a move! Did not go down. And good rebound by Miami. Staker went in to get it and did a heck of a job, and now Miami, down by only 6, wants to slow it down and needs to.
Staker, a great job of protecting the ball. In a case like that, it's generally another kick away, bounce away, and you lose it.
Rejected by McSwain, however, picked up by Staker, and Newsom tries a left-handed shot. Thompson doing a yeoman's job on the board, and he is really upset. Look at all this action underneath, Steve.
Staker gets it blocked by McSwain. Then the scramble is on. Didn't lose his pivot. A nice move by Newsom, but it doesn't go. All it receives is iron. Eddie Schilling, Mr. Pass, is in for Miami, Ohio.
Thompson on the wing, Miami the man-to-man. Wagner wheels and deals, will not go down. McSwain keeps it alive. And I think they're going to call the foul against Miami on Hannah. And the Miami fans can't believe it. Ooh-wee. That would have gone either way.
6'6 senior. Looked like McSwain had, he reached with his left arm. The officials tonight are from the ECAC.
Right.
Mickey Crawley, Larry Lumbo, and Tommy Higgins.
Well, Hannah now with 3 personal fouls. Thompson will launch from the corner and miss it all. Gets a flat-footed rebound for the Redskins, who trail by only 6 with 8:15 left on the Riverfront Coliseum clock. Lampius, number 33, playing on a high post. Hunter from the free throw line. Harper will try the follow-up, blocked by Thompson, but I don't think they'll call a goaltending on that.
Great body control by Harper, as always. He can not only put it up, but he can draw the foul. Watch him in the air. Balances, and there's no way that they can avoid fouling.
Tony Kimbrough gets the foul, Steve. That's his first, and now we watch Carlton Claiborne being walked to the scorer's table by Jerry Pearson.
Claiborne's a freshman redshirt. He was impressive in practice. In fact, he battled Hannah and Hunter for a starting spot.
He'll be checking in for Harper.
Perhaps you don't know the story. Harper, with a slight speech impediment, he did stutter and has befriended a young first grader in the area named Kevin. Kenny Payne, a freshman, comes in for Louisville. But this young first grader had a problem stuttering, and now with Ron Harper's guidance and love, he has improved his outlook on light, and they are some pair. After he makes a basket at home games, instead of the assist man, he points to little Kevin.
You know, that's what makes really collegiate athletics what it is today. That's quite a learning experience, not only for that young man, but for Ron Harper. Kenny Payne, as we mentioned, checked into the game. He's the fine freshman from Laurel, Mississippi, 6'7", 195. That's Payne with the ball now. Across the line to Wagner. 22-17, Louisville by five. Miami playing a sticky zone now. Looks like it's almost a matchup type zone, Steve.
The way Lampe and McSwain are going at it, exactly.
Kenny Crum, Wade Houston on his left, Bobby Dotson on the right. The brain thrust, Payne launches that long jumper way out of his range, and Claver tries to get it into front court and then turns it over. And Denny Crum wants to shout some instructions, but he's not going to need to because he's going to have a chance to talk to his team in person. 7:26 remaining in the first half here in Cincinnati. Louisville on top of Miami by five, and don't go away. We'll be right back.
What are we going to do at halftime now since we had Pearson on? Want to get our athletic director, maybe, Phil Olson?
Thank you. But do you want him? Or?
Ask her to ask Rogan.
Yeah. No, do you want us to try to get our athletic director? Back at Riverfront Coliseum, it's 22-17, Louisville. And the shooting percentage, Louisville's dropped a bit, Miami's improved somewhat. And the turnovers, well, Louisville normally will make a lot of turnovers, Steve Grand, the type style they play, and the Cardinal Bird. Tell you what, that bird's gone through a couple of outfits now. You think the players and everybody go through a tough way. That thing is not air-conditioned inside either.
With Schilling in there, along with Harper, but especially Schilling for Miami, Ohio, he's the guy in there to set the tempo. If they need to speed things up, which they don't tonight, he'll do it. If they have to settle down and slow it down, he'll do that too.
Kimbrough trying to get it low to Wagner, and it was knocked away, but Kimbrough gets it right back for Louisville.
Claiborne couldn't quite thread the needle on that outlet.
Wagner wants to get it to McSwain down low, and somebody reached in and grabbed Mark's arm, and it was number 14 in the red, Carlton Claiborne, for the personal foul.
When they have jammed up against Louisville down low, they have fouled. It's tough to defense the Cardinals.
Payne throws it in traffic to McSwain. Schilling with good hustle knocks it away, but Harper can't chase it down, but give number five in the red a heck of a lot of credit for a lot of hustling play there, and I'm sure that makes that man Jerry Pearson very happy. And Ellison, the big 6'10 freshman, checks back in, number 43.
He's already got a block of Harper tonight.
BT, Billy Thompson, will also make his way back onto the Coliseum court. You know, Ellison, Steve, it's very interesting. As you go to watch practice, it seems like he grows another half inch every day. They feel that he may be over 7 foot before it's all over. And, of course, Felton Spencer, a 7'1 player from Louisville Eastern, is already committed for next year.
And Ellison's coordinate.
Yeah, very much so.
Really well put together.
Schilling again with some good defense, knocking that ball away. And I'll say one thing for the Redskins, They only trail by five, and they have certainly picked up the pace on the D. Wagner working against Shilly now, and now you see him starting to trap out of that zone. There's Ellison down low, and Pervis, I think, pushed off. Gary Pearson, I think, was baiting the officials trying to get that call, and they didn't hesitate one bit as Ellison picks up his second.
That's his first and second battle.
And now it's a bonus situation, and Miami will go to the free throw line to our right. We're in Cincinnati, Ohio. Don Russell and Steve Grad, glad to have you with us tonight as we begin yet another season of Cardinal basketball, and we're pleased to have you with us here on TV 41. Steve, good to be with you tonight.
Well, you better believe it. We've had an outstanding game, Donnie, in the first game, the overtime, as Lampy goes to the line. He gained 30 pounds in the offseason, you know that? He was a stick before.
He's not a stick anymore. There's a Louisville turnover, so Miami still trails by five, and Harper will try to make it three, and does. Harper with nine. He averaged 24-9 last year, and Miami within three. Kimbrough is playing a guard with Wagner. Payne reverses, spins, shoots, and rimmed it. And now the Redskins have something going.
And he's got three freshmen in there. He's got a lot of confidence in his new staff.
He's going to get one of his seniors back in at the next break. Harper being checked by Thompson. Jumper by Claiborne is good. Alton Claiborne for his first two, and Miami has pulled back within one at 22-21.
First two in his career.
Freshman from Springfield, Ohio. Kimbrough tries to counter, but can't. And Claiborne has the rebound. Yep. Miami could take the lead.
As we mentioned, the three freshmen, that's when Miami's Redskins got in a nail that score down.
Harper rejected by Thompson. Harper got it back, lost it to Wagner. And it's three on two. Wagner with a nice move, put it up, and tipped in. It's going to be interference.
From first look at it, it looks like a good call. Harper loses it. Here comes Milt on the break. Three across, two defenders. He misses his shot, and there's the follow. Yeah, it was a good call.
Payne touched it, there's no question about it. However, I'm not so sure that Milt might have not been able to pick up the friendly bounce there. But Payne touched it, so that's of no consequence now.
Loves to crash the boards, and it's aggressiveness. It's an error of aggressiveness.
Harper had it go through his leg, and Herbert Crook picks it up and leads it up for Jeff Hall. Back to Wagner. In and out of there. And now they're going up and down, and neither team doing much offensively. There's another steal as Wagner got it off the hand of Crook. And Milt on the run goes down, and boy, I guarantee you, all 4,000 Louisville people just grabbed their heart after that injury last year.
Newsom coming in. But I'll tell you something, Miami should never have tried to thread that needle. They could have kicked it out. They were only down by one. There was no reason with 4:31 to go to have to get into the horse race again, and Pearson was upset that they tried that play.
Wagner, 17th on the all-time scoring list at Louisville with over 1,260 points. That's his fifth point tonight. As you look at the senior from Camden, New Jersey.
One-third of that Camden connection that Jenny Crum has nurtured. Along with the newest member, Kevin Walls.
They call him Ice. Billy likes the ball in the clutch. Louisville by three, 24-21.
Is it my imagination, or has Harper had problems with his hands tonight? He has not held on to several passes, and they weren't hard passes. Again, he almost dropped one there, and that was soft.
It was a nice head fake there, and he puts it in. Nothing wrong with his shot.
No, he ranks third in the country among returning players.
J. just moved under the four-minute mark here in the first half in Cincinnati, Ohio, and we're glad to have you with you. The Big Apple NIT. Louisville and Miami, and Herbert Cook can't get the roll, and the Cardinals kick it out of bounds. Both Ellison and Hall were going for the elusive ball, and it went out of bounds, and it belongs to Miami. The Miami fans are excited because their team's back within one. Cardinals lead it by one, and will return to Riverfront Coliseum after these messages.
If they find Oscar, they'll send him back.
That's our story here at Riverfront Coliseum in Cincinnati. It's Don Russell and Steve Grad bringing you NIT Big Apple Tournament Basketball. And don't forget tomorrow, or Sunday rather, tomorrow's the football game. And on Sunday, you can see the final Howard Schnellenberger show of 1985 right here on TV 41 at noon. That's football tomorrow, Louisville and Eastern Kentucky. And then Sunday, the Howard Schnellenberger show at noon here on Channel 41. That's the brain trust for Miami. Joe Barry is the assistant on the left. Had a chance to spend some time with him at one of the preseason scrimmages held by the Cardinals in Louisville, and he said, we cannot get into a running game with Louisville.
A trapping defense by the Cardinals forced a turnover. Miami says Ellison lost his pivot there, but nothing called.
Wagner and Hall are back in at the guards. It's actually the starting five back in for Louisville with Ellison, Thompson, and Herbert Kirk in the front court. And Herbert absolutely telegraphed that pass, and on the move is Harper. Ron Harper with 13, and Miami moves in front by one.
That's a real credit to the Redskins. They etched away at the lead when three freshmen were in the Cardinal lineup.
They're a veteran team. Wagner, a little bit too strong. And Lampe gets the rebound. And Newsom runs it into the front court. Blocked by Ellison, but Lampe puts it in. Lampe with the good anticipation after that nice block by Ellison.
Lampe, a local kid from nearby Hamilton. Look at the position. Ellison's gone. Hall was going back on defense, and Lampe was there.
Miami's biggest lead, three. Wagner off balance misses. Crook follows left-handed and hits it. Superb Herb with six in the game. And the Louisville deficit is one. Newsom right through that press.
They're running with Louisville.
Look a little bit like the old Spud. I think Spud Webb, who's doing so well now after coming out of North Carolina State with the Atlanta Hawks. Louisville down by three. Ellison over Lampe hits.
Hey, Ellison, the first freshman to start prior to the season for Denny since Scooter McCray. Of course, Scooter was hurt, so he didn't get to enjoy that start.
This is great NIT basketball action here in Cincinnati. We're having it all across the country, and glad to have you part of it tonight. Staker misses. Thompson rebounds. Hall brings it into the front court. All five Louisville starters have scored now, and Thompson with a nice move and gets the friendly roll. Goes all the way around and down for Billy T.
Oh, Billy's having fun tonight. Does it feel good to be back?
Harper's shot is blocked, but somebody came in from behind, and it'll either be Hall or Wagner. As you look at Coach Pearson of Miami, who paid his dues as an assistant for so many years.
It's on Wagner, and Denny was really beside himself about that chilling back in. Great passer. They've got to get him to shoot. Average is about six assists a game. At least. You know, Schilling he lives in Lebanon, Indiana. Harper with 16 points.
Well, he averaged 24-9 last year. His career high is 45, and now he has 17. Harper on. And he gets a well-deserved rest. And Chris West will check in for Louisville. Number 23, West, the junior from Louisville Manual High School, replaces Milt Wagner. So with exactly a minute to go, Miami has the one-point lead, and the Cardinals have the ball.
They want West in there with those good hands, good ball handler. They don't need his shooting because he doesn't do much.
There's Ellison from Thompson, put it in, and he's fouled.
Wait till he gets some experience. Is he going to be dangerous?
Thompson led the Cardinals in assists last year, and you can see why, Steve.
Well, he's got a big man there to go to Ellison. Perfect positioning, and the defenders for the Redskins were faked into fouling and allowing a potential three-point play. Lampy elbowed him.
Ellison
also got it.
Caps the three-point play, and Louisville leads by two. Jeff First, a 6'6 sophomore, number 53, is in the game. And Newsom trying to dribble again and does through the double team. And Clayton. Oh, my.
What penetration by Eric Newsom. And Claiborne gets the basket.
Tell you what, this guy handles the ball like Marcus King. Penetrates like Spud Webb, and I tell you, he's made this game exciting tonight.
We bring up Marcus Hink. Maybe the Globetrotters will stop Newsom.
Speaking of nice moves, Thompson with the classic bank shot, and he's fouled on the play.
Talent and experience to do something really put the youngster in his place.
There's a good look at the senior from Camden. He's a good free throw shooter at 75%. Tipped in by Louisville as Crook put it in, and he was fouled on the play.
Jerry Pearson is experiencing a coach's worst nightmare. Every time the opponents put it up, they get a three-point opportunity.
And Denny Crum very pleased of that turn of events as Herbert Crook gets points number 7 and 8. And the Louisville Eastern High School sophomore. We'll try to cap the three-point play and does.
Full-court pressure now by the Cardinals.
And Louisville enjoying a five-point lead again, and this is Newsom on the run. Throw it away, Ellison. Look at him handle it. Thompson can't get it off before the buzzer. Put it in, but clock was running down, and we have come to the end of what has been a very exciting first half of play. Louisville by 5 over Miami, and we'll return to Riverfront Coliseum after we pause for these important messages here in the NIT action in Cincinnati. Earlier during this telecast, it was Tulsa with a 63-60 upset of Dayton in the first game tonight. And in this one, the Cardinals lead it by 5 at the intermission. And Steve, it's been a pleasure for me to work with you tonight in both of these telecasts. Of course, this one just going back to the Louisville area. But we have seen some outstanding basketball. In the first half tonight, Miami did not take the challenge early, fell behind, but I tell you what, they fought back and played very well in a Louisville-style game.
Yeah, they did start to run with them, especially when there were three freshmen in the game for Louisville. We've got some exciting highlights in the first half that we'd like to show you. Now, Billy Thompson on the break. You know how artistic he is. They put this in the Art Institute right here.
He is a very talented player, and as you mentioned, he's one of the Camden connections, and Milt Wagner, the second part of that, is in the Camden connection. And
talk about talent. You got Ron Harper, the All-America candidate. Body control. Look at the follow-through with the touch. The touch. So soft, so perfect. It's a pleasure to watch outstanding players. They really, even outside of the game, they really make you feel good about the sport and the game. And sometimes you really need a television replay to verify what your own eyes saw, like you're going to see on defense.
been some good defense, too, on the other end. And let's look at some of that action from the first half.
Billy Thompson not only can get up there to jam it, but he can also get up there to jam it in somebody's face. Oh, nice block. And it was perfect. And then Harper again. You saw him with a great touch pull up. Look at the body control, the movement, the drive. Let's see him penetrate a little bit here. Effortless. Didn't touch the rim. All net.
Tell you what, it's such an interesting story when you talk about these two guys, Thompson and Harper. We touched on it, probably didn't have enough time to talk about it, but you know, it's one of the enjoyable things of intercollegiate athletics. You take a Ron Harper, an All-American from Miami, a Billy Thompson, an All-American candidate from Louisville. They spend several weeks in the summer together playing in the World University Games in Japan, and those guys learn so much about themselves that they didn't know before outside of basketball.
When we talk about up and down action, nonstop, we've got some highlight right here that'll just verify what has been going on here. Lampe goes up. He makes a nice move, but Thompson in great position. And the outlet pass, another work of art by our artist. And this is his canvas, the court. And Jeff Hall, who knows a little something about scoring, what's in this break. Oh, he ever so gently rolls it in. Just a typical sample of what we've had.
Well, we've had some great basketball here tonight in Cincinnati, and we've got more to come, so stay with us. Cardinals lead it at halftime, 38-33. We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, the attendance tonight, 10,416. That's the largest opening night crowd for a Big Apple NIT region. We thank you.
Okay.
And 10,416, right. Largest opening night crowd for a Big Apple NIT region.
Okay. Okay. Well, they've announced the attendance tonight, 10,416, and Steve Grad, that's the largest first-round Big Apple NIT crowd of 1985, and it's glad to be, happy to be part of that tonight. We've had that up-and-court action, and I tell you, it all starts when you get that ball off the glass. And I tell you what, Belt Wagner is a guy that can make it happen. Billy Thompson starts it, and watch how this will all end up.
What injury, you want to say, after watching this play with Wagner coming back and right behind the back, perfectly. Better than most of us could do with two hands in front of us standing still.
Looks so pretty. Why don't we look at it from up above the Coliseum?
Give Hall credit, too, because you've got to expect something like this and not fumble it and not lose your stride, and Hall didn't, and was able to make that nice shot.
Basketball's a pretty game when you slow it down like that, isn't it, Steve?
Yeah, that energy speed, really, when you see teams. You know, you can't believe such good play is happening so early. It's the first game. And especially for Louisville, they didn't play anybody like the Yugoslavs or Czechoslovakia. They just scrimmaged with each other. They're looking good tonight against Miami.
Well, that's only the first half of action that you've seen, and we're going to have the second half action coming up in just a moment. It's 38-33, Louisville over Miami here in the Big Apple NIT in front of a record crowd tonight, and we'll return to the Coliseum after these important messages.
run out of water?
No, I'm all right. I just wanted to hide the Coca-Cola. Did I do right?
You did.
Bring up. You had yours out there, see?
Diet Coke.
He showed the wrong spot. He showed the wrong pop.
Have you ever had to fill a pregame that long before? Not on television, radio I have. The rebounds. Okay. The rebounds.
Back out on the court, ready to get an exciting second half of action underway with Louisville leading by five. Louisville starts the second half the way it started the game, and Miami does likewise. There's the alley-oop down low. Wagner pulls up with a jumper, doesn't get it, and Harper comes up with that ball.
Miami started in the man-to-man defense in the second half.
This is Lampe, 33. And now Schilling, who runs the offense, and Harper, who can score from anywhere. He has 19 in the game. And Miami within three. And Thompson will try to counter and does.
Hannah was unable to get over to pick him up. You can't leave Thompson open.
And Thompson with that basket, Steve, has just moved to the 25th spot on the all-time list at the University of Louisville.
No small achievement of that college.
And he passed to one of his old teammates, Charles Jones, now with the Phoenix Suns. And Herbert Crook gets the miss from Lampe. Cardinals by five and on the move. There's Billy Thompson again.
Billy Thompson breaking ahead of Schilling. Schilling caught up with him. He simply went back around him and then had the mismatch. Much taller than Schilling and used it to his advantage.
42-35, Louisville by seven. We've played a minute and a half here in the second 20 minutes of play. And Harper goes to work on the baseline. Kirk knocks it away, but Harper's persistence pays off as he got it right back and stuck it in for points 20 and 21.
To Cook's credit, he didn't foul. And that would be a tempting place to foul when you make a block like that and somebody recovers. You want to just go do it again, but he held off.
There's Crook. Ball away jumper over Harper, and he was fouled, and Herbert says, hey, I can do that too, big guy. Crook in double digits with 11 as we watch it again.
How many times tonight has Louisville had three-point opportunities?
That's Harper's third foul. First team.
You see it go through the net, and more importantly, if you're a Miami fan, that's the third personal foul on Ron Harper.
And help is on the way. The bench brigade coming in. Staker. Will be one of them. Mayburn coming in. And Newsom. And Hannah come out. Both of them were beaten on defense here in the early going in the second half.
There's a good look at number 41, Herbert Crook. He's taking a little bit more time on his free throws than he did last year, and he rattles that one out of there, but Thompson gets the rebound. Crook will try it again, and he was fouled, and Louisville is really going to war on the offensive boards. Staker gets the foul, his first.
Thompson will not lose the battle of the boards. He will take on anybody, and he is in such good position that Staker was behind him, and they were going to commit fouls that way.
Crook, a 65% free throw shooter last year, has hit 3 out of 4 tonight.
Well, his biggest highlight of many was that great Florida State game. Louisville's inbounding the ball. It wasn't supposed to go to him. It wasn't his play. He just picked off his own inbound and made it, much to his relief.
And he's a very pleasant young man as he has his 13th point. And Crook will go to the bench as 44, Tony Kimbrough, who played in the first half, is back in. Kimbrough failed to score. This is Schilling on the run to Harper. Nice move. Got it. And he was fouled. Great, fast pace offense.
Schilling's
by Miami.
At his best when he dishes off. And he fed Harper perfectly. Nothing Kimbrough could do. This is after the pass. And look at the way that the body control of Harper, as he reaches back, protects the ball, keeps it away from the defender, and his body's the only thing the defender could swipe at and draws the foul.
Harper, as you can see, with 23 points already in the game. He was the Mid-American Conference Player of the Year and offensive, and also the Defensive Player of the Year. He misses, and Louisville brings it into the front court. Low to Ellison, and Pervis missed it, but Kimbrough follows it in. Kimbrough gets his first 2 points as a Louisville Cardinal officially, and Harper again charged. They'll not count the basket, I don't think. Let's see. Right. You make the call.
You don't get much of an opportunity to see it from the players' viewpoint. I don't know about that.
Questionable. Let's see if this makes any difference.
From there, it looked like the charge, but from the ground level, it looked like Ellison might have been bringing his left foot around.
And that's the fourth foul, I believe, on Harper. Thompson with the finger roll. 18 for Thompson. And it's 50-39. Louisville enjoys its largest lead of the game. Schilling throws it away.
That's an instance where Pearson wanted Schilling to put it in. He's an outstanding passer. But he might have had a better chance for the shot. Staker was breaking for an offensive rebound.
And now Jerry Pearson, as you see Harper taking that point production to the bench. Certainly going to be a little bit concerning for the Redskins. Paul loves that jumper, but he's a little bit too strong. But gets it back to Wagner. Good ball movement to Kimbrough. Kept that ball moving, Steve.
Louisville's got him on the run. They're going to try to keep him on the run with full court pressure.
Kicked out of bounds by Milt Wagner.
And Newsom's going to come back in for the Redskins. They need some scoring.
They do, and they need somebody that can move up and down the court.
They don't need assists right now.
No.
And Newsom won't get many of those.
Hear the UofL cheers in the background from the Cardinal fans off to our left. They are here in punching. This is Newsom now with the ball working against Wagner in the Louisville man-to-man. Ron Harper's on the bench with four personals and carries 23 points over there too. Good head fake by Lampe, and Thompson took it. Denny Crum pointing something out to Billy, probably saying, hey, don't take that fake.
That was set up by Carlton Claiborne's great pass, a knee-high rifle to Lampe. That's Thompson's first.
You know, Steve, that's a point I want to make. Thompson got in a lot of foul trouble last year because he had to do so many things with all the injuries. And as we look at Lampe going to the line, with all the support staff back out there, Thompson doesn't have to do all those things, and as a result, probably will not get in foul trouble as much.
Thompson, didn't he bring the ball up last year and finally pass up and get down low? He did two, three positions at a time in the game.
Lampe misses the first one and gets the kind bounce on that one for his third point. And it's 52-40, Louisville. And Milt Wagner with it. The Hall will hit.
Oh, he's a great shooter. His slow defensive
deficiencies are made up for with that kind of shooting.
Newsom takes it through the traffic, wide open as Claiborne, and he hits it. Claiborne with his third field goal in the game, and it's 54-42. Wagner all the way, flips it in, but it'll not count. He was fouled prior to that shot.
His second, and the Redskins fourth.
Baker gets the foul, and we have a break in the action here in the Coliseum, and the Louisville fans are excited about Mitt Wagner and all the Cardinals as they lead it by 12 with 15:55 to go.
Quick side glances, flashes and silhouettes.
Didn't Miami take a lead in this half?
Yeah. No, not in this half. They did last half.
Oh, okay.
Well, I thought they came back.
Right.
The largest first-round crowd in the Big Apple NIT of over 10,400 is seeing Louisville lead by 12. And look at the shooting percentages. Breakdown by half, Steve, that as we look at it.
Miami came alive in the second half, but Louisville stayed alive, 67% to 64%. And no matter what the Redskins did, the Cardinals upped him. That's why he's dancing. Can you blame him?
She, believe it or not.
I believe it. Absolutely. And Harper's back. They haven't got much time, even though it's 15:55. They, with 23 points, no matter how many calls, you got to go get them now.
Plenty of time left, but as you mentioned, Steve, they have to put themselves in a position where they're hanging in the game, and they're still there. It's a long way from over. I don't want to give anybody an indication that it's anywhere close to being over.
If they try to keep running with them the rest of the game, it could be over.
I get a two-shot foul on 55 points. Yeah,
now they're going to call Billy Thompson for the foul, and I thought I heard the official shout that it'll be a two-shot foul for holding, grabbing a player. Let's see if we
Thompson
can pick it up.
Thompson isn't used to somebody getting by him at will and freezing by him. And in the low post, he reaches her. Oh, absolutely. Ellison was in front of Claiborne.
Well, the fans can't figure it out, but it was an intentional foul is what you're calling. So that's why Claiborne will go to the line. On a South High School, he's a redshirt freshman.
And a southpaw.
He can pull the Redskins within 10 here. Thompson gets the miss and brings it up on the dribble himself. Now over to Wagner to Hall. Back to Milt. Slapped outside and picked up by Harper, and Harper lost control of it but now chases it down.
Great credit to Milt Wagner for slowing what should have been an uncontested pass break.
Milt is always drawing the toughest defensive assignment, and he's on Harper now. This one rimmed by Staker, and Wagner gets the rebound, tries to get it up the hall, and a nice hustling play by Claiborne to knock it out of bounds. You know, a lot of people hear about Milt Wagner and his offensive prowess, but Steve, he always draws the toughest defensive assignment, too, for the Cardinals.
And he hasn't slowed down despite the fracture in the fifth metacarpal bone on his right foot.
Sixth and seventh point, and the Cardinals open up a 13-point lead. We're glad to have you with us here on TV 41, and boy, what a way to open up the 1985-86 Cardinal basketball season. Newsom trying to wheel and deal, but Hall cuts him off. Channel 41, the home of the Cardinals all season long with you this year in our local package, and we'll have a holding foul, much to the discredit of the Cardinal fans. And it's going to be on, I believe, Ellison. No, Kimbrough gets it.
Kimbrough's second foul.
Danny Crum decked out in rather bright red jacket tonight. And on the common foul, it comes into Lampe and now to Newsom. Wagner gives him some room and just dares him to shoot.
Ellison doing a good job defensively on Lampe down low.
There's Harper. Got free, and he has 25, but keep in mind, too, also four personal fouls. Just over 14 minutes remaining in regulation here, and the Cardinals lead it by 11. Kimbrough kicks it back to Wagner. Ellison, what a nice follow-in.
Ellison's got outstanding court sense, especially noted for a freshman to have that, and good positioning, good awareness, and he has been where he's supposed to be.
A lot of those instinctual things that you just can't teach.
He's 4 for 4 from the field.
And he almost came up with another steal, and now he rejects the shot by Newsom. Claiborne tried to follow it in, but he was fouled on the play. 44 is Lamont Hammer checking back in.
That's Newsom in Hall traffic there. Fakes out Wagner. There's a rejection by Ellison. Another good look at Ellison going way up there.
Look at that arm span. He crosses the lane. And he puts those arms out.
The pride of Savannah. And we've seen him also do some great outlet passes too under the defensive board.
Ellison in high school averaged 27 points and 19 rebounds. Was a McDonald's All-American. Claiborne cashes in once on two occasions. And it's 58-46, the Cardinals, and Wagner gets out of the double team with help from Kimbrough. Cardinals want to set up the offense. You can hear Hall yelling, set up, and now he wants Wagner to come up and begin things.
Switching on defense by Miami, and it's a good thing.
Hall will take that shot all day. Missed it. Thompson missed the follow slam attempt. Ellison kept it alive and put it in. He just played some volleyball up there. Finally stuck it in.
I took a look at Denny after that shot, and the man is glowing. I mean, he's glowing, but this man's only a freshman, is Ellison.
Ellison with 11 in the game, and it's 60-46. Here's Miami's man, Harper, and he will be fouled. Schilling will check back in, number 5 for Miami, and Staker will go to the bench. Thompson gets his third personal foul. And Harper, with 25 points, will go to the line.
Well, they're going to make him inbound.
Said he was not in the act of shooting, so on the common foul. Miami will be in the bonus on the next Louisville person. Schilling misses. Kimbrough had it, lost it. Now Hannah missed the shot, but he was fouled by Ellison.
We just saw a real oddity there for Miami. You saw Schilling, who normally passes every time he gets the ball, take a shot. He was open, he missed, but they were glad to see him take the shot. Then you saw Newsom, who shoots whenever he touches the ball, feed off and set up the play where they'll at least go to the line.
There you can see Ellison in some foul trouble with his fourth personal. And Hannah, 81% free throw shooter, misses his first try of the night.
He started off last season in great shape. And Swain back in for Ellison, gets the big hand. But getting back to Hannah, who's at the line, he started off great and then lost all his confidence during the MAC regular season and played great in the NCAA.
Well, Hannah gets his first point of the night. And 60-47 with just over 12 minutes remaining in this Big Apple NIT game here in the Coliseum. Don Russell and Steve Grad with you, and Kimbrough with a nifty move but missed the shot. McSwain tried to keep it alive, and as Hannah tried to chase it down, he lost it. So the Cardinals will trigger it in and the corner of the forecourt.
You think the Louisville defense will allow Miami to overcome a 13-point deficit in just over 12 minutes?
Likely, and I think it'll be interesting to see what they do. Now they clear out for Wagner, and Milt with a pass down low to Crook, who got too far underneath the basket. Here's Harper with it. Oh, most traveled. Schilly to Claiborne, and Kimbrough with the rebound up to Wagner. Wagner, stop and go move, blocked Harper, picked up Kimbrough for the bucket.
I wish I could get my windows washed the way Louisville's washing those boards. I mean, they're cleaning everything up there, and Miami will not get a second attempt.
There's a great slam dunk by Ron Harper.
That's the only thing you can do to prevent them getting a defensive rebound.
He had 93 of the slam dunks last year, and that would have the exclamation point. And he has 27 points in the game at 62-49. 11:05 left on the Riverfront Coliseum clock. Here's McSwain over Hannah. A little bit short. Crook kept it alive. Schilling is pushed out of bounds by Crook. And Herbert quickly helped Schilling up off the hardwood.
Cardinals very impressive here tonight, and you still have to remember that the freshmen really are just learning the basics, and they still are up against a very good team by 13 points.
There you see Coach Crum talking to McSwain. Crook gets the foul. That's his first. Crum in his 15th year. Hard to believe he's been there that long, and that man, Jerry Pearson, has been at Miami that long, but only his second year as the head coach. He really paid his dues. You know, that doesn't happen a whole lot anymore, Steve. You normally will see somebody completely new come in. Somebody that's been an assistant that long get the head job.
It's great to fire stability. Schilling at the line. Interesting story about Schilling. He's from Lebanon, Indiana. And in the summer, he practices at Purdue. And he became a good friend of Rick Mount, the former Purdue great. Pearson practice hoping that Mount would teach him a little more about shooting.
There you see our point story and our score here in the Coliseum. Miami looks to be setting up in a zone. With 10:42 remaining in the game here, Cincinnati, Ohio. Glad to have you with us tonight as the Big Apple NIT is in full swing. Winner of this game will be back here in the Coliseum on Sunday night for an 8 p.m. contest with Tulsa. Winner over Dayton in overtime. McSwain goes to the basket, and Claiborne reaches in for his second personal.
Claiborne's been active tonight, but I guess a year of redshirting, sitting there with bottling up with you, you want to make it every playing minute. And he's playing a lot more than they expected.
Mark McSwain, a junior out of Atlanta. 64% at the line, McSwain last year, and he's short with this one.
I think McSwain, I'd almost bet the house that he's got the largest hands in the Metro Conference, maybe in all of basketball in college.
They are incredible, I'll tell you that. They didn't help on the free throws, though, as he missed them both. And a 12-point Cardinal lead, but Miami, the Redskins with the ball, and plenty of time, just over 10 minutes. And Harper can't get it to go down, and Milt Wagner comes out on the run and went off Hannah's foot. McSwain to Hall, back down to Kimbrough. That ball went off everybody and finally goes through off the hands of Tony Kimbrough.
Nifty move by the freshman.
A 14-point Louisville advantage. And a half-court trap. And now Schilling wants to settle it down offensively for the Redskins. Schilling will take that jumper, and Kimbrough skies for the board. Outlet pass to Wagner. Wagner wants the wheel and deal, and does, and doesn't get the roll. Schilling saves it in, but he'll throw it right to number 20 in the white.
Wagner was working on Hunter, rather, with Harper with four fouls. He knew Harper wasn't going to get himself out of the game at this point, and it was a smart play.
Melts made some great moves tonight, but his timing may still be off just a little bit. Hey, he had it slapped away, but Wagner gets it back and has it stolen away by Schilling. A good defensive play by the youngster, and Harper is really fouled by Wagner.
Every time Milt hits that deck, hearts stop palpitating for just a brief second. And that was a good play. Harper was trailing the play, and the behind-the-back pass by Schilling. He doesn't need to see anybody. Milt fouls him very alertly following up that play, because even with a fast break like that, chances are that Schilling isn't going to shoot.
These guys really go at it, don't they? They throw their bodies, they give their bodies away for this game.
The men on the court, for both sides, they have a lot of heart. And you have to play with the intensity that they do. They make it look so easy on television.
And Harper with 29 points and playing his normal great game. We have 9 minutes left of this game in the Coliseum. Cardinals lead it by 12, 64-52. Don't go away, because we'll be right back. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. All right, great. Well, the 4,000 Louisville Cardinal fans that are here tonight at the Red Pom-Poms that have a 12-point lead to cheer about at this particular point. With 9 minutes remaining, as you look at the foul trouble, Harper, of course, we've talked about, Steve, but he certainly has been the point man as expected for Miami. And Ellison, of course, Louisville with the advantage of having a little bit more depth.
A lot more depth, frankly.
And don't forget, we talk about basketball. We're just starting this NIT, but the 1985 Metro Conference Tournament will be held in Freedom Hall on March 7, 8, 9, and that's the ticket info number. And, boy, that should be something. Memphis State.
Oh, the Metro. I tell you, I love Metro basketball.
You did that for a while.
Yeah, following them, and so many great teams in there, and it's almost a pit. Best one standing. You know, of course, Louisville and Memphis State get to play, but there's a lot of other good teams in there. And I know the Cardinals don't take them lightly.
Miami sets up in a pressure zone defense, and Hall needs some help, and finally McSwain comes to the rescue. And now Wagner wants to set up the offense. Yep, has his pass knocked away, but McSwain gets it to Kimbrough, who can't roll it down, but Kirkner tried to follow and had it knocked away. Louisville has really gone to the offensive board.
And that was textbook rebounding by Herbert Krupp, one of the great offensive rebounders ever at Louisville. He also runs well.
Yeah. 8:25 left.
You've got to watch some of the play away from the ball, too. The battle for positions and the movement without the ball, that's what sets up a good play.
Great pass to Herbert Krupp. Yeah, the freshman Kimbrough, the assist and the basket to Herbert Crook, the Louisville sophomore. 66-52. And Schilling now will back it out. We just moved under the 8-minute mark in this game. Here's Harper with a nice pass from Hannah. Harper with 31 points in the game. Boy, I tell you what a player he is. Looking at a first-round draft choice there, probably, Steve.
A lot of people say he wasn't recruited extra heavily outside of the area because they didn't know about the recruiting of his attitude, but they didn't realize it was a speech impediment that made him sullen, and he mainly would say hi and goodbye. He was very embarrassed, but he could play.
And this man could play as Wagner with that patented move through the lane, has
an opportunity for a three-point play, and Billy Thompson also checks back into the lineup.
Here's Milt, the elder statesman now, in traffic, great body control. That's how it should be done.
Wagner will go to the line and can give the Cardinals a 15-point lead, which I believe would be the largest in the game for Coach Denny Crum's club.
That's only the second point for him in this half.
Has his ninth point. And we have a break in the action at 69-54 Louisville, and we'll return to Riverfront Coliseum in just a moment.
The largest opening game crowd for the Big Apple NIT regional. All four teams, thank you.
Oh, please, you guys.
Talk about a work of art.
I tell you what, that's a work of art. Not all the basketball. Oops.
I don't think Russell will be able to finish the game now.
I'm out. That's our story here in Cincinnati, Ohio. And if you look at the shooting percentages, Miami improved slightly in Louisville on an even keel. And we have pretty things other than great basketball, and I understand she wants to come to Louisville. Is that right?
I wouldn't doubt a lot of people would like to go to Louisville. I know you'd like to have the company of wonderful academicians attending the university where you spend so much of your time.
Right.
Let's get our mind back on a game here.
It's all part of the excitement, color, pageantry of college basketball here on TV 41.
TV 41 will not miss any of the excitement here at Cincinnati.
There's that half-court pressure, and Harper, who's had an tremendous game tonight, as everyone expected. Carried a burden on his shoulders, and here's another opportunity, and he almost knocked that ball through the backboard. It was almost pinned between the rim and the glass. Matter of fact, it looked like it was, Steve, and then he pulled it out of there real quick.
It's a good thing it didn't stick, because he might have had a shoulder injury. He was right up against it.
Go, Newsom!
This is Newsom trying to back it out and start the offense over again. And now Harper, as Wagner is on his assignment defensively. It's 69-54 with 6:45 left on the clock, but 3 seconds on the 45-second clock. And Newsom had to force a long jumper that would not go down. And Thompson wants to take it coast to coast, and he charged up a block. Wait a minute. A travel.
No, you're right. Each official had something else. Each one.
And there you look at a final. Boy, what an upset that is. West Virginia, after suspending several players, Steve. 75-58 over Auburn. Boy, I tell you what, that game in the Hartford Civic Center, and that's our story right here in Cincinnati. So it'll be St. John's and West Virginia. Up in Hartford. We're in Cincinnati here, and Harper has excited this crowd, missed it.
Nice
great pass.
Pass
by Schilling, and Hannah can't get it down, but boy, Schilling did a heck of a job of even finding Hannah. I think he knew where he was. Look at this. Yeah,
208 assists last year, and that's how he does it. You can't make all your assists from straight on threading the needle or filling in the seams. You got to do some of the extraordinary type of passes, as that one was.
Now he is 13th in the nation in assist in terms of returnings, average just under seven, as you mentioned.
Well, in the NCAA tournament, this guy had a great game against Len Bailey of Maryland.
Out of the clear blue sky, they didn't expect it.
Going against a superstar like that, and they almost pulled it off.
Well, here's the third part of the Camden connection.
Devin Walls. Football fans know he's the cousin of Everson Walls, the Cowboy defensive back.
I mean, can this guy score 81 points in a game in high school?
You know, this is his first game ever officially as a Louisville Cardinal because he came to Louisville 2 years ago out of high school. Missed last year with that knee injury. As you look at Pervis Ellison ready to check back in, playing now with four fouls, and Walls, who averaged 44 points per game in high school, made everybody's All-American team. And Timbro leaves, so one freshman replaces another. And a nice panoramic shot from underneath the basket. Beautiful Coliseum, and it's been fun to be here tonight in a record crowd of over 10,400. An NIT Big Apple first round record. And the Cardinals lead it by 13.
Cardinals have dominated the boards, and that's what made it such a big lead.
Ellison misses. Kenny Payne, who's also in the game, almost tipped it in, and here's Kevin Walls with it. And Louisville fans have been waiting for Walls action for some time. He has that right knee heavily taped with the brace. Right now on the court, Steve Grad, you have two seniors and three freshmen.
Payne is in there. And the reason that Walls has got that brace, he's had bone spurs removed from that knee. Andy Ronan, who grew up in the Virgin Islands but attended an academy in Virginia to learn a little basketball, checks in.
Oak Hill Academy, and they have turned out some outstanding players. Thompson, great pass over to Kenny Payne. So the senior does the freshman a favor.
Boy, if you're going to get an opportunity, Billy Thompson will make sure you get one if you didn't need one, and Payne does and got it. First 2 points in his career.
I'm sure the freshman says thank you very much.
He was so nervous about getting back on defense, he didn't even have time to acknowledge Thompson patting him on the back.
71-56 Louisville, 5:13 remaining. Newsom tries to go to the baseline. Now Walls picks him up on the D. Schilling from way out, and it's nothing but net. His first field goal of the night, his third point.
Not for lack of trying, he did put up a couple of earlier bombs that hit the iron.
This is Walls, and he can handle the ball, as you can see. As Thompson came up to get that Milt Wagner pass, somebody pushed him from behind.
In the meantime, Denny is giving the freshmen some instructions, some on-the-court practice learning, especially Payne. He's still shouting to the freshmen. Get ready to back up on defense, he hollers.
And Thompson gets the free throw. I don't know if we'll get a chance or not, but over on the bench in street clothes is another freshman. His name is Keith Williams from Louisville Seneca, who has a cast on his hand. He has a finger injury, but I talked to Keith today, and he said the cast is coming off Monday, and I'm going back to practice. We have a violation on Kenny Payne. There he is. There you see Williams in the street clothes. Thank you, guys. Great job there in the truck. Boy, Williams is a fine young man, and he talked to him in the hotel today. He says, hey, I want to get back to it. I can't afford to miss any practice. 72-58, and we have a timeout called by Miami. Second timeout by the Redskins as you look at Thompson Sky for the board. And we're in the Riverfront Coliseum, and the Cardinals have the better of it. And we'll return in just a moment.
Audrey, what's your last name?
Well, the winner of this game, and at this point, the Cardinals have the advantage as you look at the leading scores in the game. No surprise, Harper, 31 points for the Redskins, and Billy Thompson, 19 in that balance for Louisville. Besides Thompson with 19, Crook has 15, Ellison 11, Wagner with 9. So you can see the difference in the balance favoring the Cardinals. As I was saying earlier, the winner of this game will take on Tulsa Sunday night right here in the Coliseum. And should it be Louisville, we'll be right here with you on TV 41. Miami with the ball. Louisville settles back in a zone. You don't see this very often, but with the youngsters in there, Schilling shoots over the zone and is a little bit short.
Well, he's not the zone breaker.
Harper can't get it to go down, and Walls comes up with it. And we'll bring it into the front court to Wagner. Wagner one-on-one, a little bit frustrated as he might have twisted his ankle a little bit.
But Walls can really see everything on that court. He's got amazing vision. Peripheral straight ahead. He spots the people that are open instantly.
There's never a guy that looked like Nate Archibald in the style of play. It's Kevin Walls.
Although he's stockier physically.
Walls slaps it away from Newsom. And Walls will get the foul as Staker comes in. You're sitting at home. How'd you like all this coming right at you, Steve?
This is typical of the action we've had tonight. Newsom drives. He likes to penetrate. Walls likes to stop him, but at the expense of a foul.
Newsom has his 11th point, but his first of the second half, and I guess that's the key there, Steve.
I'd say this is the guy who's scored the most points in Toledo school ball history, and they've had a lot of outstanding players there. That's a tribute to Newsom.
It's a 12-point Louisville advantage with 3:45 to go, and Walls loses the ball. And they call Kevin Walls for a foul. I think they said you stuck your knee out, big guy. That's his second personal. That's right. Kevin Walls. Missing Emerson Walls earlier, Steve.
Yeah, that would have been pass interference.
Been.
Was his cousin, you know.
I would say Emerson probably would have liked to have been on the basketball court last week when Chicago was in Dallas. And I know you're a Bears fan.
Well, I'll tell you, I'm not a bandwagon Bears fan. I was back in the days when they couldn't find a quarterback to save their life. Free Walter Payton, post-Gale Sarah.
It remains 72-60 with 3:35 to go. And Wagner was being held viciously by Staker. Now Wagner gets loose on the baseline, and the shovel pump shot is no good. And it's knocked out of bounds, and the Cardinals maintain possession.
What a treat for Denny to be able to play his freshman now in this opening game so much.
Ellison misses, but Thompson gets the rebound and in frustration puts it back up. No. And Harper will come out on the run and wants to take it coast to coast, but Wagner keeps him from doing so.
At this point in the game, he's going to go one on two and probably still could score.
You know, the thing about it, Steve, 72-60 with 3:13 as we watch it again. Watch this reaching in right there.
3:13. Oh.
How many guys could score 72 and not have that their career
high? Couldn't score that many points because nobody was guarding me.
The great thing about Hall now that he's back, and he has been very consistent in his career. Just consistent and good.
Back to a 12-point Louisville advantage with a minute 30 remaining, and Harper, I think, was held by Jeff Hall. As you can see, that's number 3 on the Ashland, Kentucky native.
From Fairview High School, the pride. You may see some people filing out. Those are the Dayton fans who were here earlier and saw their team lose to Tulsa 63-60 in overtime.
But the Louisville fans are not leaving because of several reasons, Steve. They're excited about what's happening and also the fact that they're getting a chance to see these young players.
And the
action.
Fact that they expect to be back here Sunday against Tulsa Sunday night. Get your money's worth in this Big Apple tournament, and the talent tonight has given everybody their money's worth.
Harper makes one out of two, and as the Cardinals get the rebound, Miami has whistled for a personal foul. It's on Todd Staker. So big Pervis Ellison will walk to the free throw line, and let's see if there is a reach-in foul.
Whoops. Oh, yeah, he got him. The way he's played tonight, Pervis really would be justified in not having to be nervous. He has done a very, very excellent job.
You know what, too, we didn't have a chance to mention, as Ellison misses. Ellison playing with a slightly pulled hamstring, and also he stepped on a stump on campus and had a stone bruise.
He's got that bruise under his foot.
Whoa, Thompson with what a rejection. Newsom will not get it to go down. Hannah Thompson blocks it again. Call to Kevin Walls for the layup. What great, great defensive basketball there. And it was all started by number 55, Billy Thompson.
Well, a minute ago, the Cardinals do not let up. They're a class act all the way. They could have backed off with this lead.
Walls saves it to Thompson. Over to Kenny Payne, and Payne will put it in.
Thompson is Santa Claus tonight for that young man, the freshman. He figures 3-on-1. I don't need the basket. It would sure be good for his confidence. And Kenny gets it.
Miami takes a timeout, and we'll take a break in the action with 39 seconds to go here in the Coliseum in Cincinnati. The Louisville fans are excited, and that's why, because of the great play by Billy Thompson. We'll be right back. It'll be Louisville and Tulsa on Sunday night at 8 p.m. and you'll be able to see it right here on TV 41, and we certainly hope that you'll be back with us.
Emptying the bench time for Miami.
There's Kevin Walls off the West, and West is fouled on the play. Now let's see if we can pick up who's in the game for Miami.
Well, I've got Jeff First in there. Rusty Doyle, number 54. First is 53. They've got Denard Newell, number 12. Andy Ronan back in, number 20.
This is Chris West at the line, and West misses the free throw.
Ron Harper's back in. He's a swingman. I'm surprised he's played so little tonight.
And West has his first point of 1985, and it's 81-65, as you can see graphically. And Miami with the ball is Newell. Ronan is double teamed. 10 seconds remaining. Will Allegis is in the game. Had it. Lost it. Walls had it. And he dropped it out.
So. The Cardinals refuse to let up. They are playing tough defense right down to the final seconds of this game.
And the fans are on their feet and appreciate it. 3 seconds to go. Long jumper by Newell is no good. And Louisville has advanced to the finals on Sunday night of this regional of the Big Apple National Invitational Tournament. As you see, Denny Crum and Jerry Pearson meet at midcourt to exchange congratulations. And Coach Crum and the Cardinals get out to a good start in 1985. It's 81-65 our final, and we'll be back to wrap it up from the Coliseum in Cincinnati in just a moment. Well, that's the matchup that we'll have here on Sunday night in the Riverfront Coliseum, and your Cardinal Connection, TV 41, will bring you the action live at 8 p.m.
here at the Riverfront Coliseum, as it will be Louisville taking on Tulsa, as Tulsa upset Dayton in the first game.
Absolutely, but the way Louisville played tonight, I'd have to say they're a heavy favorite over the Golden Hurricanes, who are just learning a new system. They got away with it tonight, and they did well. I mean, I think their coach, J.D. Barnett, was kind of low-key about it, as you saw prior to this contest, in praising his team. But after all, they did win, and they're going to have a real matchup, though, a real tough job to go against the Cardinals, as does everybody when they play Louisville.
Well, that's 8 p.m. Sunday night here on TV 41, but I think you have some people that you would like to thank.
Our stat man, Jeff Schneider. Audrey Whitley, our floor director, did a great job. Our producer-director, Roger Schwing, always outstanding. Our production supervisor, Cliff Plumer, and our technical director, David Bremer, another outstanding job from the production staff of MISLU Television. We'll be covering all the games of the NIT Big Apple preseason tournament. And boy, Wall's having a great, great time scoring in his first game after being redshirted. And of course, the crew at WDRB always outstanding on their Cardinal broadcast.
And our thanks to Roy Hamlin and Chris DeMeo helping out. And the Cardinal Bird had a lot to cheer about tonight. And we certainly had a lot of fun. And we'll see you on Sunday night. For Steve Grad, I'm Don Russell. Good night from Riverfront Coliseum. Again, the final score, Louisville 81 and Miami of Ohio 65. Good night, everyone.
Overtime, Tulsa 63, Dayton 60. For Don Russell, I'm Steve Grad. Good night from Cincinnati. Pressing defense.